Greetings and holy nuts.
You gotta send me a lot of stuff and it goes deep. Like there's just, there's so many packages. So I had to bring it over here into my storage area where my games and stuff are at because there's more room here than there is in my house. So let's get to opening this. First one here is from someone with the last name Garrett. The other first name was covered up. Oh my, Gravis Ultrasound Ace discs? Yeah, from Ray Garrett. This is a Gravis Ultrasound Ace 1.0. Yeah, I've been wanting to do a Gravis Ultrasound video, and this is one of the cards that I was hoping to get before I do that. That's so much smaller than the Gus Max I have. So thank you very much. Got one here from Ripley. Hopefully there's no xenomorphs. Whoa. Greetings again. I was supposed to send this off a month ago. Whoops. Hello, from RVA. Oh, interesting discs. These Trek arts are quite fascinating. What? Oh my God, a wood grain fidget spinner. I've never used one of these. That's officially happened on my table. Never thought I'd see the day. Oh, neat. From Tyler R. Thank you very much for the letter. It's my Royal 66 typewriter. That's fantastic. Go back from whence you came. I just noticed my camera wasn't in focus until just now, so sorry about those first couple openings. But yeah, this one's from Li Jing, something from China, and well, didn't appear to survive whatever it was. Well, the case didn't survive, but it appears to be a burger MP3 player. That cracks me up. I don't know who actually sent this to me, but thank you. That goes well with my Burger King headphones. Got one here from Matthew. Red Baron, Ace of the Sky, interactive flight game. This looks like something that was packed in with like some Red Baron pizza or something back in the day. That is awesome. Thank you. Got one here from Timu, who, if I'm correct, is a Patreon supporter for quite a long time. Oh my. Oh, that is a Nokia 9300i. I don't have anything like this, actually. It's like their business smartphone. Seriously, they called it a smartphone from 2005. Dude. Well, doesn't seem to turn on, but obviously I might just need a charger to something. Thank you very much. This is really cool. Got one here from Nils, N-I-L-S. Ah, you got mail. Oh, well, thanks. I'm glad you're enjoying the videos. Sorry, I'm just now getting around to opening this. Wood grain fidget spinners, focus spinners, whatever. They're just the thing nowadays. You know, I'm gonna have a collection of wood grain fidget spinners. I guess that's just my fate. This one is from Gaming Fancies. What is all this? We got a loose copy of School Tycoon. Candyland Adventure. I remember seeing this in stores. Actually, no, I remember seeing this in the public library. Ah, and Star Trek Next Generation of Final Unity. So thank you very much. We've got a little one here from David Croshaw. I was actually in touch with him after he sent this, apparently. He was offering a Next Station color with stuff, and that ended up going to Rob of Obsolete Geek on YouTube, which I'm fine with. That's probably more his thing anyway. But he sent this instead. Conway's Game of Life on a DVD-R. So this is a short film, 16mm digitized film I put on YouTube. It sounds weird, it's based on Conway's Game of Life. I don't really know what to expect at all there, but that's cool. Business software sampler. And let's see, what is this? Discuss? Well, thank you very much, David. These are interesting thingies. I don't know what in the heck to expect from that video, but I'll give it a look. Got this one here from Andrew. That unfortunately didn't survive the trip. Well, Beavis and Butthead Virtual Stupidity did, because that's a pretty substantial box. Alice, this is a box I've been wanting for a very long time. It wasn't in the greatest condition anyway, so it's not a huge loss, I guess. Microsoft Plus Companion for Windows 95. I can at least fix these up as far as getting them flattened. I mean, these are free. I'm not gonna complain. Thank you. I'm gonna have to start going faster. There are so many more boxes over there. This one is from Jason. That is really taped up. This is so much stuff. Ah, apparently the motherload of demo discs. I already see a bunch I don't have. Yeah, I fear that tuck tape, all right. That stuff was intense. There's a lot of things in here. I'm not gonna go through them all, but like loose games and tonic trouble. And yeah, I've got so much stuff here, so my apologies if it sounds like I'm going quickly. It's because I am. There's so much stuff to get through. A package here from Brian. Yeah, sent me a cute cat a while ago. I'm packing peanuts, lol. PBA Bowling for Windows 95. This is actually a Bethesda game. Seriously, Bethesda Softworks. Yes, that one made bowling games. Launch something? It's like a computerized music video kind of
QuickTime software. Interesting. Oh, there's a demos. That's cool.
This one's from Ben in Australia. I don't know about you, but I've never been in Australia.
Nice packing job.
Short message from Ben there. Thank you very much.
This is so much Lynx stuff. Goodness, look at all of these add-on packs. That's super cool. And then there's Lynx 386 CD here. Another course. Ooh, Cricket 2000. I have never played any of the EA Sports Cricket games. Always been really curious. They're obviously not, I don't think, sold in the US. Oh, Way Things Work 2.0. Very cool. Did not have this in box. Fantastic package. Thank you, Ben. Got one here from Randy.
Ooh,
grid paper. Doesn't know for sure if these cards work, but if no reason to believe that they don't, that's okay. We got a Diamond 3DFX Voodoo card here, and another one. So it's a nice little SLI set right there. And looks like we also have an Appian Graphics Duet AGP. It's an S3 chipset card. Awesome. Thank you very much.
Got one here from NES Forever. Thanks for my order. I didn't order anything.
Gubble 2. Non-violent gameplay. That looks like my kind of weirdness. Thank you very much to whoever dropshipped this my way from an Amazon seller, it looks like. Here's a really heavy one from Eshelman Molding and Casting. I'm assuming they use their company shipping service. Feels like a laptop or something. That is a wonderful IBM ThinkPad. Look at this thing. Wow. Apologies, I don't know who it's from this very instant, but I will put that right down there at the bottom of the screen. Thank you very much. What a cool laptop. Got one here from Nicole. Ooh, this is pleasant. Nice recycled looking paper here. What the handwriting? Dude, I'm impressed.
Texas Instruments.
TI-2500 electronic calculator. Look at that. I mean, the fact that it's in the packaging, it's got the original documentation, even has a letter from John Brewer Jr., the vice president of TI. These early 70s calculators, just brilliant. Thank you so much. And that packaging was, the handwriting, oh my goodness. That one here from Vinny. This is neat. Microsoft cordless wheel mouse. And an early Microsoft wireless mouse for Windows NT and 98, made in 1999. Pretty darn good condition too, thank you. Got one here from Chris. Greetings, here's a Nintendo PC flight stick we discussed. Holy crap, yes, we did discuss that. It's like the worst of both worlds. Packing peanuts, but not quite. And then it's like the worst peanuts nobody likes to eat. That's a nice touch. Oh man, this is wild. I admittedly don't know much about this, but this is indeed a Nintendo controller for PC computers only. That's a little bit redundant. ATM machine. That is the widest rear end for a joystick. What are you thinking, Nintendo? Thanks for sending this. Got one here from Veronica. Ooh, hey! This is a sealed copy of The Day the World Broke. That is much better condition than the one I have. I mean, mine's not sealed and it's kind of beat up. On two sealed copies while thrifting. Very cool. Weird little VGA adapter. Oh yeah, it's not the weirdest thing. It's like a Macintosh adapter. I use those when I need them. Thank you very much. Got one here from Joe. Okay, here we go. We have a Oxid Magnum for the Mac Classic. That's super cool. So Chinese Windows games, Japanese PC 98 games, and a Y2K bug. What? The merchandising for Y2K was out of control. He's so cute. What a cool box. I've only seen a couple of pictures of this. Look at this packaging. Oh, I don't know what that is, but that box art is fantastic. It's a DVD-ROM game, too, so it's a little newer. Along with the rest of these. What? I just like this stuff, man. What's in here? Is it discs? Oh, they're just like packed in a corner. That's wild. Oh, man. I don't actually have a PC-98 that'll run any of these, but hopefully that'll change someday. I have one here from the Netherlands to LGR with love. From Sander Witt. What a cool name. Free bonus, the white label collection with one of my personal favorite games. Whoa, what the heck? I have seen white label releases before. In fact, I think I have one for something Rally, not Screamer Rally. I think it's like Sega Rally Championship, but never seen this package before. I dropped by for homebrew beer. Yeah, Netherlands homebrew beer. Whoa, I wish there was the beer in here. Yes, yes, yes. Micro Machines V3 for the PC in the box. Oh, that is neat.
not in English, but it doesn't matter. I have a loose copy of this in English that I got from the UK years ago, but the box has proved elusive. Thank you very much. Got one here from Bill S. Look at these things. This is gonna be a nice box of goodies. Wow, man, just wow. There is some cool cards and things included in here. NamePal, a computer address book that fits in your pocket. Oh, I recognize this immediately. 53 hours of AOL. Had this disc back in the day, and this little booklet I looked through. This is one of the main things I was wanting to check out. It's a Turtle Beach sound card, a Santa Cruz. I remember seeing these in various stores being demonstrated in the late 90s. They were really cool. Thank you very much for all this. Got one here from Eric. Oh, yes. This is a Sam's Club edition of Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 3. What is this here? Ha, Dragon Point and Speak. Does this come with the... Yeah, it comes with a microphone. Alone in the Dark, The New Nightmare in the big box. If it actually comes with that flashlight... Well, it has the box for the flashlight, but not the flashlight. However, this looks pretty generic, so maybe I'll be able to find, like, the flashlight to replace it. Ooh, F-22 DID Air Dominance Fighter. Yes, indeed. And Alone in the Dark 2 CD-ROM version. I did not have this at all. Also, I had no clue it came with Alone in the Dark 1. That's awesome. Now I just need Alone in the Dark 3. This one here is from Tim. What's up? This side, apparently. Yeah, Thirst is my favorite show. You know, I'm glad. Please review the attached warning I found recently in a box of C64 floppies. Oh, never let anything mechanical know you were in a hurry. That is quite the warning. Somebody was like really burned when they made that, huh? Oh, calculators. So we have here a wonderful TI-55. Needs a little bit of TLC, but looking nice. Has the case and the manual. Oh, and here is a TI-30. Oh, wonderful example. And again, case and manual, that just makes me very calculating. In this case, our manual with this one, but this is just a really neat little calculator anyway. I like the way that this has that sort of very flat brushed look all the way across. Oh yeah. TI-1025. Sort of beat up, but here is a Echelon, a 3D space flight simulator. Commodore 64 and 128 version. I think I just have the PC one. Access Software's Lipstick Plus. Yeah, that's absolutely oddware. Voice activated control headset. Vintage software. I got a manual. Strike Commander. Hey. I've got some loose games in here. Various ones. Now that's really cool. July 1992 Compute Magazine. Oh, whoa! That ad for Dagger of Amun-Ra. Fox Sports Golf 99. Well, thank you. These are awesome. Got one here from, I believe it's Jan from France. Is this wood grain paper? Oh, man. Apparently also did the way things work, French and US versions in JavaScript. Dang, that's a neat box. Did not know it was in French, but then again, I've never checked. Oh, what is this? Come get some. It says FormGen 3D Realms Entertainment. I'm assuming, yes, Duke Nukem 3D of some version. Awesome, thanks a lot. And here's one I've been curious about for a while, or since it showed up a few weeks ago. This is something from Adult Swim. Welcome Adventure to our Kingsway operating system. I have heard of this, and there is a Steam code which is already going to be used by the time you see this video, so I don't care if you see it. There's a foam sword. Well, that's a thing. I'm really curious to try this game out. Not sure if I'll do a review necessarily, but thank you, Adult Swim, for the game and the sword. smells like merchandise. This one here comes from Eric. I was just excited. Started opening it without reading the name. Public Domain Master Discs. That's a lot of them, too. Well, that's going to be quite the imaging process. I hope they're in good shape. Thank you very much. I'm quite curious. Got another one here from an Eric. It's another Eric. We'll call this one Washington Eric. Oh, you're from Spokane. Spokane. I always wondered how to pronounce that.
Whoa.
That's rad. I have a very similar one to this, but this one looks a little bit different. Thank you very much. I've always liked that box art. Whoa. Cordless Super Mouse. I'll say, look at the friggin' size of this box. This thing is like 4 pounds. Do you really need a mouse guide that big? Unbelievable. It's 600 pages, just the one guide. This kind of stuff is what makes retro computer collecting pretty amazing sometimes.
Oh, yes.
Nice, nice, nice. This is a beautiful copy of King's Quest V here. It's got the sparkly cover, like glitter and stuff in there, and the nicer artwork. There's a really stupid version of this box, which I have. And this is in way better condition anyway. It's like an embossed manual with all the cool things going on. I wonder if anybody still has that shirt. If you do, please send it to me. Hard drive mounting kit. Wow. Still sealed by Reveal. I know them mainly for their sound cards. Man, that's just neat that it's like still sealed. Thank you very much. Another one here from the first Eric from Arizona. Oh, retail archaeology. I know you. You have some interesting videos for sure. Check him out too. Does some cool things with Goodwills and whatnot. So if you like thrifts, you'll probably find something to watch there. Loose copy of Microsoft Office, but yeah, man, Anarchy Online Beta 3. That's interesting. Limited edition CD-ROM Entertainment Utilities. Collector's edition, apparently. Copy of Star Trek Klingon, the FMV game. I have never played this. Always wanted to. Odyssey into the Mind's Eye. The computer animation journey continues. Well, that, I don't know what to expect, but it looks delightfully mid-90s. Oh, and last but not least, here we have an AOL disc. Looks like it wasn't even shipped out to anyone. There's no label. It was never opened. Dang. That's pristine. That one here from Chris with a K. LGR, here's the gowl for the 1350B. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, so this little gowl chip should let me use Game Blaster add-on synthy things for certain Sound Blaster cards, the early ones. Never seen this before. 1994 Holiday Lemmings in this little box. I've reviewed it, but I have never seen that packaging. Wow, what the heck is all this stuff?
It's a Hercules card.
1994 Hercules VLB card of some kind with a Sing Labs chip on there. That's sweet. This is a lot of cards, man. Dang, check out this diamond video card with the daughter board on there. Is that for like MPEG maybe? Not entirely sure. This is a lot of cool stuff, man. Thank you. Okay, now we're getting to the really big stuff. Starting with this one from Dennis. Okay, so first off, this is from the Dennis that I bought the sealed IBM AT from a while back. He no longer is selling them. I guess he's not with the company, but he sent me some other stuff, including these wonderful things. Check this out. These catalogs and just like magazine clippings. So yeah, this is pretty great. It's like a PS2 seller's like little resource thing here. Check this out. Installing the options in your personal computer. PS2 model 55SX, model 90 XP46 quick reference. Perfect for mine. Hands-on basic for the PC Junior. Now that is a delightful book. A PS2 XGA adapter A. This is an MCA card. Very, very cool to have. Although now I gotta try and track down the XGA display for it. There, yeah, good luck. Some new documentation for a memory expansion board. Let's see here, PS2 system library. Check out that key lock replacement. That's wonderful. Yes. Original IBM PC documentation. It looks like somebody had a six-pack plus installed in theirs. Pretty popular add-on. Got the Exploring the IBM PC disc right there. Digging that inventory checklist on the back. Here we go, is the guide to operations to the PC. All these discs, I don't know what DFI is, but here's another Exploring the PC. Got MS-DOS 3.3, very handy. The diagnostics discs are incredibly handy for the IBM PC. It didn't have any of those. And then there's this, IBM ThinkPad expansion cartridge. Yeah, there's pretty much the idea of how it works. Looks pretty involved. Man, this thing is intense. And in case you're wondering, no, it won't work with that IBM ThinkPad that I just got. You can see the connector in the back is quite different. So maybe I'll track down the ThinkPad for this expansion cartridge. Oh, it's ridiculously awesome. Thank you very much, Dennis. Another one from Chris Garcia, who sent me a Sun computer that didn't quite survive shipping last time, but this one looks to have held up much better. Oh man, I can't even get the whole thing in the frame. That is a ridiculous Gateway 2000 desktop, the P5166. It even has the little base that it sits on. I love these computers. This one looks really nice. I've been planning a Gateway 2000 desktop video for a while. I've got one or two of these kinds of towers. Look at all this room. It's like a server. Thank you so much.
Here's another one from Chris. This is about the biggest one that I have today. Just about. Well, unfortunately, it looks like it was pretty beat up and damaged. There's a crack here, big dent there, and well, there's all that. But it actually doesn't look like it was hurt too bad. But we'll see once we get inside. It came with this, looks like VGA to BNC connector thing. Not really sure what that's for because it actually has the 13W3 connector connected to the monitor. But again, look at that. Pretty beat up. That can be bent back into shape. I'm just not sure about the internals. We will see. This is a GDM 17E10. This would be a great display. Hopefully it still works. Either way, thank you, Chris. If anything, for that gateway, because that held up well. Okay, we are to the last three boxes, and they are all from Jonathan. Anyone have any guesses as to what this is? Because I bet you won't guess what it is. What it is rusty. But honestly, it's so uncommon that I was happy to take it in just on the off chance that I could use it for parts, because this is a personal computer, XT286, and these are not the most common machines. This is my second one. I do have another one that is also not working and needs some work, but I'm hoping that by combining the two, I'll be able to get them put together and do a video on it at some point. All things considered, it looks all right, other than there's a lot of rust in the back, so I'm assuming maybe some components might have got damaged, but whew. This is the next one that came alongside of it. Bet you won't guess what this one is either. This is a Princeton Graphics System Max 12, which is essentially a clone of the IBM PC5151, but I believe this has an amber phosphor in there instead of green. It also doesn't have a built-in cord like the 5151 or even the 515X series of monitors do. You got that little 9-pin right there. I'm gonna have to find one of those cables. I actually don't have a 9-pin video cable on its own. Yeah, July 1986. And the final item of the day. This is a leading edge VGA monitor. Looks like a nice little maybe 13-inch, 12-inch model or something, which is perfect. I've been wanting a monitor that looks like just like this from this era, this size and everything, to work with a few of my 286 and 386 machines, because I like showing them off with era-appropriate displays. This one, though, looks great. And Leading Edge was quite the brand back in their day. September 1992, CMC 1414BA. And this is the letter that came with it that I just now found. So thank you very much, Jonathan, aka Veraxis on YouTube. Yeah, awesome. This is wonderful. Thanks so much to everyone who has sent me all these things. And you know, I don't normally show the aftermath of these videos, but it's typically an absolute disaster area afterward. But that's okay. It'll take about an hour or two to clean up and it'll be all good. Thank you so much once again for everything you've sent. This is just the most incredible bunch of stuff, all arriving within about a month's time. It's literally overwhelming. It's a good thing, but at the same time, I may have to start declining some offers because I've already got quite a bit coming. So please don't be too offended if I have to turn you down for a donation, but still, the support is hugely appreciated. And as always, thank you very much for watching. We'll see you in the next LGR.